Hi everyone, welcome back to Chinnan Logics. So today we are going to deal with current affairs of June 20. So regarding international affairs, national affairs, appointments, reports and sports news. So let us move with the first topic regarding international affairs. That is to what? France to get the world's largest powerful magnet. So this powerful magnet, this will be the replica of what? For the process to power the sun. So this is a replica to what? To power the sun, we are saying, right? So in this, what are involved actually? Here the nuclear fusion reactions are involved. That is to what? To produce, that means to power the sun and the stars. So nuclear fusion reactions are going to take place, okay? And this world's first magnet, we are saying, right? So that magnet will be acting as the central solenoid. What we are saying? Central solenoid. If you see here the structure of solenoid, you can see clearly about that France, world's largest magnet. And here we are seeing that this is also make the heart of the world's largest fusion reactor. That is what ITER. That means the meaning of this ITER is, in Latin it is the way. That means through this magnet we are going to power what? That means France is going to power the sun as well as stars. So here the nuclear fusion reactions are taking place, right? So now we can what we can say, we will know about the fusion reactions. If one, like we can say, if two atoms are going to form the single nuclei, then that process is called what? Fusion. That means while they are forming the single nuclei, regarding that, here the amount of energy will be released or absorbed. So that energy which is releasing or absorbed, that is called what? Fusion. That means the total reaction process is called nuclear fusion reactions. And here as well as we can cover the fission process also. So fission is nothing but the single nuclei will be there, then it will be divided into the two atoms, okay. Now what will the energy released while breaking? That means fusion means while forming the single nuclei, fission means while breaking the nuclei. So that process is called fission, nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. So in this magnet process, what is, that means whatever we are concentrating, that is about fusion reactions. And this will be the central component for what? For the France energy project will be there, no? So for that part, this magnet is going to become the central component. And here in this experiment, how many countries are going to participate, right? So in this international experiment, 35 countries and more than like thousands of engineers and scientists are involved regarding this world's largest magnet. As well as the main objective is to what? To prove the feasibility of sustainable fusion reactions to create the energy. That is the main objective of this, what we can say, this experiment. So where it is taking place? It is in the country called France. Is it clear now between fusion reactions and fission reactions? Let us move for the next one regarding world's third largest diamond, which is founded in Botswana, South Africa. And before moving into the topic regarding third largest one, we have to see what is the first largest diamond and the second largest diamond in the world. So when they have unearthed. So the first largest diamond is unearthed in the year 1905 in South Africa. And mention the name of the first diamond in the comment section. Okay. And here if we see, this is the first largest diamond we are seeing. And what is the second largest diamond? That is Lesedi La Rona. This is the second largest diamond and which was unearthed in the year 2015 in Botswana only. So here we are saying Botswana region, right? So this region is regarding what? Regarding the, this is the largest producer of diamonds in the region called Africa. So in Africa, Botswana is the place where we can get the diamonds. And here if we see regarding India, where are the diamond mines are there? So that is the region called Panna. In Panna town, we can see many diamond mines. That is in Madhya Pradesh. So concentrate this part also. So we have to know even regarding our country also, no? So like in India, it is in Panna region, Panna town, we can say it is in Madhya Pradesh. So there we can find the diamonds. And here now, if we move into the topic, like what is the weight of this third largest diamond regarding, as well as where we have found it. So this is found by the company, what we can say, Debswana Diamond Company have unearthed the world third largest diamond in the Jwaneng mine of Botswana, that is in South Africa. And this is the largest producer of diamonds in Africa, and this diamond weighing is 1098 carats. That means carats we are saying, this is a unit, that means measured for what, purity of gold or else pure form of stones we can say. So that is a about carats. Now this third largest diamond is there, no? So that is the weight of 1098 carats. That means it is lesser than the second one. So what is the weight of second one? 1109 carats. This is the second largest diamond weight. So now in the single topic we have covered regarding what, regarding the world's first largest diamond, second largest diamond, and the third largest diamond is in news today. Okay, let us move for the next topic regarding HTBT cotton, herbicide tolerant BT cotton. So BT cotton we are saying, Bacillus thuringiensis is a bacterium which will form the Cry1AC gene. Okay, so from this BT bacterium they will take the Cry1AC gene and they will combine it with the cotton plant. Why they are combining it with cotton plant? Why? Because it will produce a toxic material. Okay, that is for the pest, as it will act as a pesticide. And to for what? To prevent the boll worms will be there, no, in cotton, to prevent that this toxic Cry1AC will be useful. So whenever the worms eat that plant leaves or something, so this toxic material will go inside the digestive system of the worms, then the worms will get died. So what are the benefits of this HTBT cotton we are using? Why? Because in this toxic material already they have genetically involved in it. So here we are saying like advantages, no? So advantages like the farmers can use the pesticides very less and the weeding process like it can't take place, as well as if you see the production will be more regarding the HTBT cotton. So here HTBT cotton we are saying this is a genetically modified crop, and if we see India has allowed this HTBT cotton genetically modified crop, the only crop allowed to import to the India, that is what, HTBT cotton. And here genetically modified crops we are saying, that means they will get what we can say, they will combine the genetic, that means DNAs of one plant to the other plant. So because of some other modifications they will do the for the plants. So if we see mustards like that, okay, and you can see like soya beans, so these are the genetically modified crops in India, and imports are allowed only for the HTBT cotton. So regarding this import we are saying, right? So regarding this import, many illegal sales are taking place every year. So now this year also illegal sales has risen up compared to last year. So last year it was only 30 lakhs illegal sales has done, but in 2021 75 lakhs illegal sales, that means more than doubled than the last year. So this illegal sales should not be done. Like how we can prohibit this illegal sales, like only the regulators and advisors, that means certain company will be there, so only that seeds will should be taken by the farmers. So on that packet seeds will be there, no? So that seed packets should be recognized, some what we can say like images should be created on it, that means it is belongs to certain company, some brand images should be done, so that illegal sales should be reduced. And here BT cotton we are discussing. So BT cotton is the only transgenic crop that has been approved by the Center for what, for the commercial cultivation in India, as well as this genetically modified crops are there, no? These are to produce what? To produce an insecticide to combat the boll worms, as well as it will act as a common pest. Why? Because here toxic material is produced by cry one AC gene from BT, right? So from that BT, this cry one AC is taken, and this will produce toxic material in the cotton plant. So if bollworms eat these plants, then it will die immediately. So this is the process regarding HTBT cotton. Now let us see, like Ibrahim Raisi, Iran president. So he is Ibrahim Raisi, became the new president of Iran. So why it is in news means, our prime minister, Indian prime minister Narendra Modi, has congratulated him on his election, and he also said that means he also, along with the congratulations, he also willing to say what, that he is looking forward to working with the him and to further strengthening the warm ties between India and Iran. So once, whenever you are free regarding the international affairs, if we are dealing, so once see the ties between the two countries. So now, like many agreements we are seeing between India and Sri Lanka, so like the daily we are seeing in news, right? So whenever you are seeing like these ties between the two countries, mainly with India, you refer the ties between that two countries. Now today it is in news regarding India and Iran. So after the class, once you see the relation between, relations and ties between India and Iran, you will get one like an idea. So like anytime if you see further current affairs also, it will be useful for you. And now he is the president of Islamic Republic of Iran. So now Modi is looking forward to strengthen the ties between India and Iran. Like that, he has congratulated the president of Iran. Next, regarding national news and state news, we will cover. So what is the first one is regarding transgenders. So in our society, we have to respect the transgender. At least as a human beings, we have to respect them. So we should not discriminate transgenders in the society. And even government has bringing up many schemes and portals for the transgenders also. If we see regarding the Protection of Rights of Transgenders Bill and Act in 2019 and new rules regarding transgenders in 2020 has came up to improvise the life of the transgenders. So here we are saying transgenders, like hijras we can see, no? So like trans men or trans women, even that are not matched at their particular birth. So what we can say, like many are discriminating and disrespecting the transgenders. So to overcome all these problems, government has bringing up many upcomings and developments regarding the transgenders. And if we see like why these rules and bills has passed in the parliaments, why? Because we have to provide equal opportunities for them regarding job sector, or else we have to give the shelter for them. That means we have to allow the persons to live in our homes, as well as if we see like regarding education sector, health sector. So everywhere they should provide, like they should get some equal benefits with us. Okay, so this is the main objective of the government. Now here it is in news, and also if you disrespect, that means if you misbehave or some disrespect has been done for the transgenders, you will be like prisoned for 6 months to 2 years, as well as a fine will be imposed on you. So be careful and respect the transgenders in the society. Now if we see, like the news is regarding the Odisha government. Why? So Odisha government is providing the opportunity for the transgenders to apply for the jobs regarding the state public services, that too in the police department. So what are the post is, they can apply for the post of constable as well as sub inspectors in the police department. So that is why it is in news regarding transgenders. So the capital, now we can cover the static part. Okay, here the capital of Odisha is Bhubaneswar. Next, let us move for the next topic. What is that? Indian Army for the first time created the vacancies for the Nepal women. That is for what? Nepali women we are saying. So that too in what? In military sector. Once you refer the treaty called Treaty of Saugali, okay? So if you refer this, you will get to know the India and Nepal border disputes, as well as like various topics you can cover under this. So whenever you are free, refer this topic. And here for Nepali women, we are, this is the first time India is creating the vacancies for the in this military sector. And why? Why? Because now if we see, it wants to continue the recruitment. That means Nepali youth, it is recruiting, but women recruitment is the first time. That is to bid the widen the scope of the youngsters. So their scope should be widened. That is the main objective, to create the vacancies in the Indian military sector for the Nepali women and men. And if you see here, the eligible Nepali women, that means how they can submit their applications, they can submit their applications through the online process. So now it is in news regarding India and Nepal. So once you go through India and Nepal relations also. Next, regarding appointments. So what is the first one? Renew Power, CMD Suman Sinha recognizes as the SDG pioneers by UNGC. UNGC we are saying, United Nations Global Compact. So this is the strategic initiative that supports the companies, that means business leaders, which that means who are responsible for what? Responsible for the regarding human rights, corruption as well as environment. What are that? Human rights, environment and corruption. So now regarding Renew Power, we are saying that is Suman Sinha. So why he has selected the chairman of Renew Power? So and by whom? Like SDG pioneers will be selected by UNGC only. Why? Because UNGC is mainly supporting regarding these three areas. No. So here it is regarding the sustainable development goal number 7. That means his works are towards clean and affordable energy. So here clean and affordable energy we are saying, that is like we have sustainable development goals, in that the 7th one is clean and affordable energy. So clean and affordable energy is nothing but like creating and the electricity through the various forms, like which are not harmful for the environment, that are what, like solar energy, wind energy, hydro energy. So these are the various like energy sectors they are considering to what, towards the affordable energy. And here his work is to what, to advance these 7th sustainable development goal. So here SDG pioneers we are saying, no, what is the meaning of pioneer? Pioneer means the first person to settle in that area. That means the advances they are bringing up regarding that area, the first person, that person is called pioneer. So here mainly to, that means the persons who are working towards the sustainable development goals, advancements of these goals, that persons are selected by the UNGC. Now he is the one person regarding the goal number 7. Okay, that is what is we can say SDG. So now he has recognized as a chairman. Who is that person? Suman Sinha, chairman of Renew Power. It is in news. Is it clear now? Next, regarding ranks and reports. So the first one we will see about the World Competitive Index rankings. So in that, India stands 43rd position out of 64 economies. So India's rank is the 43rd. And you will raise the questions regarding this World Competitive Index is released by whom? Every year this is released by IMD, Institute for Management and Development. So this institute will every year releases the World Competitive Index. So this World Competitive Index is released like considering the various factors, that is regarding what, like all the countries' economies, efficiency, government like functions they will do, they will look after the government working and efficiency. So all these factors they will consider and they will give the rankings for different countries. So here our India rank is 43rd. And here you can see this is of COVID-19, that means the impact of the COVID-19 they have examined and they have given the rankings. And if we see here, mainly this promotes the prosperity of its people by measuring what, economic well-being through the hard data, and the surveying response will be there, you know, from the executive, that means from the government, regarding that survey responses they will give this rankings. And if you see the top ranks, that means you may raise the questions regarding the top countries also. That is, the first one is topped, and the first is Switzerland, and the second is Sweden, and the third stands at Denmark. So these are the top three countries which has stand in the world competitive index, and India's rank is what? 43rd. So remember India's rank as well as top three countries. It will be useful for you, and this is released by IMD. So these are the important areas you have to concentrate in this topic. Next, if we see regarding sports news. So former Mumbai left arm spinner Ankit Chhabra. So Ankit Chhabra, he is going to resume in the cricket. Why? Because in 2013 he has like involved in the IPL spot fixing. That means bettings will be there, no? So in that areas he has involved. So now that dispute has been cleared by whom? By BCCI. Board of Control for Cricket in India. This was cleared by, that means this spot fixing will be there now. So that case has now, it has cleared by the BCCI. So now he is going to resume in the cricket. So he is Ankit Chhabra, and in that spot fixing he has involved with the other person, that is S. Srisanth. And here BCCI we are saying, right? So this is the governing body of cricket in India. And it is established in the year 1928, and if you see the headquarters is at Mumbai. And here we are dealing with sports, right? So here who is the sports minister, like what is the ministry we can see? Ministry of Sports. So concentrate on the ministries also. So here the ministry involved is what? Ministry of Sports. Okay, this is all about the today's current affairs, and let us discuss the previous classes answers. The first one is regarding NASSCOM. So the NASSCOM full form is the National Association of Software and Services Companies, that is established in the year 1988. And IDBI, I have said you, what is that? Industrial Development Bank of India, established year is 1964. Everyone verify your answers, those who have mentioned in the comment section, or else if you are unaware of these answers, once know, at least today itself cover these topics. It will be useful for you in the next classes. And let us conclude our class. Everyone stay safe, stay home, even in this pandemic situation. I hope you people are doing well. Thank you. We will meet you in the next class.